If a player can be quietly spectacular, it's Kawhi Leonard, who has distinguished himself as one of the most dominant superstars of his era. His smothering defense and clutch scoring elevated him to success on the game's biggest stage, winning Finals MVP with two different franchises.
Hey.
Leonard.
Destroyed.
The best two-way player that we have in the NBA.
Yeah, I remember early in his career, and I was with the Clippers at the time. I think it was myself, CP, Chauncey, and maybe a couple other guys, Willie Green, I think. We're all playing like fake GM on who would you take, and I was always a big fan of his then. He wasn't really even playing that much. I just saw what I saw in short bursts and limited minutes, but I saw his feel for the game. He always made the right play. He was so fundamentally sound, and he was impressive, and obviously, lockdown defender. He was still evolving as a shooter and scorer, but he could do everything on the court. And I didn't see this for him. I can't say I'm, you know, like Nostradamus and I saw everything coming, but I saw the ingredients was there. And he just had to build upon that. He did that, and that's what made him special. And that's why I'm a fan of his to this day.
And what would you like people to know about you?
I'm a fun guy. Obviously, I love the game of basketball. It's just more a question you have to ask me in order for me to tell you about myself.
So Kawhi is just a freak of nature. You know, his hands are the size of a frying pan, and the way he handles the ball and worked on his game. He wasn't known as a great shooter coming in the league, and now he's a great three-point shooter. I felt like he always added to a game. He was known as a great defender, as a great rebounder. There's really no hole in his game, and he's definitely fun to watch.
Probably one of the most underrated and underappreciated on the 75. You put Kawhi Leonard on any team in the NBA, and they ultimately become a championship contender. When you talk about some of the best small forwards to ever play the game, Kawhi Leonard is your guy, right? He's what you want. Defense, scoring, handles, unstoppable, hustle, heart, all the intangibles necessary, and probably the guy that his peers fear the most.
Shot clock at 9. Murray takes it and tried to jam and was rejected at the rim. Kawhi Leonard is doing it all. My goodness.
Looks like he blocked it with one of those fingers.
His defensive dominance was the first thing that you noticed early on when he was in San Antonio. Like, when he started out, it was like, dude, this dude's different defensively. Like, you know what I'm saying? And it took you a while to see it because he's one of those dudes that can easily fly under the radar because he doesn't say anything, doesn't make any expressions. But it was just like you just started to notice. Then you started to see it in the scouting report. Like, yo, don't mess around with the ball in front of this dude. Like, you know what I'm saying? Then, and I can remember him blocking one of my threes, and I was like, I got a fast release. I didn't get a lot of threes blocked in my career.
And that's why the nickname is the Claw.
You can't even disagree with that. Just let me take it from you.
I think because of the Spurs system and the way that things was ran, like, all right, he's just an easy plug and play guy. Like, he's just exceptional with that. And that's just like, they never like rebuild, they just reload. And Kawhi was like a perfect plug and play guy. But as we all soon found out, Kawhi was, you know, very special, very different. We saw the demonstration that he put on when he left the Spurs and became, you know, more of an isolation player, you know, in a league where everyone was trending towards the three-point shot. He still was dominating 17 on end. Like, he really, really understood the game of basketball. He played at his pace, even when you try to speed him up as a player, and that's tough to do. Like, defense always, like, gear up to speed you up to make you turn over or rush you in your decision-making, but Kawhi is one of those guys that always played at his pace.
Leonard raises up.
Crazy to think how Kawhi's offensive game evolved and eventually caught up
to his defensive game, where he has been known as one of the best two-way players the league has seen.
It's incredible because you typically never see a guy that started where he did. You know, no one ever saw him becoming a great offensive player. I remember talking to Greg Popovich about it. He said, look, we thought he'd be a good 3-and-D guy. They never in their wildest dreams envisioned him becoming arguably the best player in the entire world. And for a stretch, he had a really strong case.
And no better example highlights his career than Game 7 against Philadelphia. You're on the call with Kevin Harlan.
Is this the dagger?
I can't believe how it went in. Like, typically when you're hitting game winners, you might bank one in or, you know, you might rattle one in. But to see that ball hit the front of the rim from the corner and bounce once, then bounce twice, and then to see everybody's eyes and then finally have that thing go through the net, I was in a state of shock because I had literally not seen anything like that. And for him to be able to deliver on that stage in that moment really speaks volumes to who he is as a player. And really, you think about him being MVP of the finals when he was 22 years old and some of the other things he's been able to accomplish. It's pretty incredible. And he's still a young man. I mean, he's still got a lot ahead in terms of what he can accomplish. Can he win a third title with a third team? That's what we got to wait and see.
I worked out with Kawhi when San Diego State first got drafted. It was during the lockout, playing 2-on-2, 3-on-3. And in my way, I was like, man, this guy's elite defensively, but he has a long way offensively. I remember being able to score on him. He'd be able to block my shot at times if I didn't get separation. And then defensively guarding him, I didn't think he was that tough. And year after year, he got better to the whole point where when he's in San Antonio during those, you know, losing the finals, winning the finals, you could see it coming. And then in Toronto, you couldn't guard him. With the spacing, with the knowledge of Pop, and then him to put it all together and go to Toronto and lead him to the championship.
Following an iconic buzzer beater and a dominant performance in the finals, your 2019 Bill Russell Finals MVP is Kawhi Leonard.